We live in a world of numbers, and the world of tennis is no exception. In this game of skill and chance, even small digits can make a big difference. At the University of Amsterdam, Frank Klassen and his colleague Jan Magnus use the power of statistics to unlock the secrets to the game.
So when we were watching TV and you listen to the commentators, they have these typical wisdoms like starting to serve in a set is an advantage. And we as statisticians then questioned, is that really true? You have one player instead of a team, which is easier to model. So that makes tennis an ideal sport to investigate.
Using almost 100,000 pieces of data, the team compiled their findings in the book Analyzing Wimbledon, which they claim separates fact from fiction.
Many people believe that starting to serve in a set is an advantage. The idea then is that if you start serving, you are one game ahead, so that it creates less pressure and therefore it's an advantage. But what does the data tell us? If the normal probability of winning this first game or winning the game in general is 60%, then this bonus in the very first game brings you to 67%. So actually it's a 7 percentage points bonus, which is quite substantial. So the overall conclusion is that in the very first set, it is indeed an advantage of serving first, but in all other sets, there is no effect at all. When the umpire says new balls and one player showing the balls to the other one, it's like I'm under control, I have the advantage. So the question again is, what do the data tell us? First, these new balls are more difficult to control. That by itself is a negative. But if the first serve is in, then the probability that you win the point is also higher. So first, fewer are in, so that is a disadvantage. If the service is in, then you win more points, so that's an advantage. And it turns out that the total effect of these is just zero. Winning streaks is basically, if you win one point, then that will create some momentum and that you will also have a high probability of winning subsequent points. And then it turns out to be, yes, that there is this winning mood, but it's much, much smaller than people typically think. So do these players behave differently when they are in the winning mood? We observe in the data that there are fewer first serves in, more aces, more double folds. So this all indicates that they take more risk, which is kind of consistent with the idea that when you're in a winning mood, you get more self-confidence, so you take more risk. So that's what the data tell us. Sometimes you hear people say, with statistics you can't prove anything, so that they are misleading. I look at it a bit differently. If you use statistics in a proper way, that you can really learn from the data and thereby from human behavior. After all, these tennis players are humans, special people, but we can learn from their behavior also about human behavior in society.